Mikhail Travers has asked how to paint the armor of the Hermetic Blade from the Thousand Sons. So in today's video, we're going to show you how to do that. But the first thing we'll need to do is undercoat the model. And as you can see here, I've gone with Corax White, which is key to this color scheme. The colors we'll be using, we'll start with mixing nylac oxide and lamy medium. And this will go over the whole of the model to give that eerie kind of glow. Then we'll tidy back up with a little bit of ultramarine gray. Then for the trim itself, we'll be starting with Retributor Armor. We'll then shade with Reichland Flesh Shade. And then finish off with a highlight of Stormhouse Silver. So with that first mix, I'm just going to add a couple of dollops of lamy medium to my palette. I'll be using a medium layer brush for this as well. And then one dollop of nylac oxide, which should be runny enough. And then we'll just start applying that onto the model itself. So if you do get it on the trim, don't worry because, well, we'll be painting over that in a minute or two anyway. Slap this on to your heart's content. Once that mix is dry, we're going to apply Ultramarine Grey to a load of the armour panels. You might want to do a couple of thin coats of this, but keep them with a small layer brush. Just keep it nice and smooth and take your time. You want to concentrate on the raised areas whilst leaving a load of that shade in the recesses. With the armour paneling now dry, we're going to apply Retributor Armour to all the trim. And I've thinned this down with 2 parts water to 1 part Retributor Armour. That'll just make it a lot easier, especially when painting over white areas, just to fall into those recesses. And you might find you get a natural highlight as well. You need to do all the trim, and I'm using a medium layer brush for this. With that trim now base coated, we're going to shade all over that area with Reichland Flesh Shade. I'm going to keep this into the recesses as much as possible, and I'm using a small layer brush just for better control because we need to be really neat at this point. Once you've allowed plenty of time for that shade to dry, we're going to start highlighting with Stormhouse Silver. We want to keep this to some of the key areas or areas where the light's probably going to touch it the most, so coming from the top like so, and also things like the rivets as well. Just a little dab on the rivets like that. You've also got some gems here, which you can also just paint silver. Quite nice. And there we are. The armour of the Hermetic Blade is now done. I hope you found that useful, Mikhail. Keep sending those requests in, and we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.